Hey, it's me, GUV. Oh, I planned to do like a Mario one, but I halfway forgot, and so I just kind of brought it up at the end there, at the tail end. Well, anyways, hey, it's me, GV. Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen, to Let's Play The Elder Scrolls V Skyrim Special Edition. So sorry, in the last episode, that there was no sound, there was no game volume. Just to explain in more detail why that happened, as most of you guys know, I've been uploading some virtual reality videos using my new Oculus Rift and touch controls. Oh, let's try... What? What? What are my thoughts on all this? I don't know. It seemed like the wolf bit me.
Keep an eye out for trouble. It's only a matter of time.
Okay, but as to your question, it seemed like the wolf bit me, and then it killed himself because I'm just so powerful. But I think one of you guys actually shot him with an arrow, which would make more sense.
Keep an eye out for trouble.
Yeah, I'm the legate here. You don't tell me what to do. You guys keep an eye out for trouble, silly men. Anyways, yeah, to explain a little bit why there was no volume in the last episode, that was because I've been recording videos with my Oculus Rift VR, and it's easy, when I record it, basically I have to pull the sound directly from the Oculus, whereas I usually play video games, and then the sound is coming out through the computer, you know, so I pull it through the computer, so... Forgot that I had it through the Oculus, and thus it recorded the Oculus, but the Oculus wasn't even on, and it didn't record any gameplay sound. So sorry that happened, ladies and gentlemen. Hope you guys enjoyed that episode anyways. Regardless, we're going to go ahead and jump right into this one. We have two quests here. Actually, just one. Both of these, wow, we've cleared up pretty much everything as far as real quests. This one, we still need to do. I've been putting this off far too long. I need to just sit down and go through all of these and figure that out. I've been crazy busy as of late. I haven't had time to do that, but I think I'm going to do this off camera. I think I'm going to, or maybe I'll just record and I'll make a super cut of like every getting the last 9 gems. This one we cannot complete though, so this one will forever stay in our journal. However, miscellaneous, we can't do that. But we have locate Sindiri's folio from the wreck of the Strident Squall. We have ask Dior about Baldur's disappearance. That might actually be... I thought all of these were related to Dragonborn, but I think just this one. I think this and this are related to Vanilla. Let's see. Yeah, this one... Wait. Oh, wait, no. Maybe it is in Dragonborn. Okay, we'll see. Regardless, we're going to get to work on... This one locates Sindiri's folio from the wreck of the Strident Squall. And I think, yeah, Kolbjorn Barrow must be in Solstheim because it's not giving us a quest marker to locate it. We'll do one or two more things, and then we will return to Neloth, who hopefully has discerned the final location of the final black book, the seventh black book. And then we have all of those magical powers together under our belt. Now, let's see. Hopefully this gives us a quest marker. It doesn't. What? We have miscellaneous there, and we have this one active. The Strident Squall should be in Dragonborn, I'm pretty sure. And it should be a ship on the coast. So what we could do is just travel to various locations around the coasts, the coast of Solstheim, and see if we can find anything. Here's one, and no, we don't see anything. Let's go... Gosh, do I remember where this is? Can I possibly just figure it out of my using my own volition? I see a little bit of debris sort of right over here. Let's travel to Bloodskull Barrow. We'll just try 2 or 3 locations just to see if we're lucky. I'm really surprised that it doesn't give us a location for this. It must not be in Skyrim. I'm pretty sure it is in Solstheim. Okay, there's no ship that we can see on our map. Solstheim obviously is a very small place, so it shouldn't be too hard to locate it. Why don't we go to Bristleback Cave? Of course we can't. Of course we can't. There's something nearby, and yet again, as usual, we can't see it. Okay, let's walk this way. There we go. All right. I cannot wait in air. Well, I'm not in the air. My feet are firmly planted on the ground, you silly game. Okay, let's see. It might be on the other side. There's some sort of harbor, though, and obviously a lot of reeklings appearing all over the place. What is this? Is this icon in the vanilla Skyrim? It must be, right? It must be, especially that place near Solitude. There is a harbor, and I'm sure this has the same icon, but you just don't see these all too often. Here's North Shore Landing, though. Okay, let's... Whoa. Ah! Is that a larger than normal mud crab? No, that looks about normal. I'm vaguely remembering there is something. I could be wrong, though. What about this guy? That seems pretty big. Okay, what do we have in here? Probably an East Empire strong box, no doubt. Yes, I was correct. Okay, let's see. Where's our sweet spot at? A little over here to the right. Yeah, I've got a tender touch. I said I've got a tender touch. There we go. And inside, flawless sapphire. In the last episode, we were looking at the exquisite sapphire, and that actually is the same, same little icon there. Potion of Ultimate Healing, and that's what we want. Oh, we're carrying too much to be able to run. All right, let's test out Mirak's sword. Yeah, that's a lot of... Oh, there we go, there we go. Yeah. I think we just killed him, maybe. I remembered something about this location. Are you still alive, sir? Let's see. Yeah, Old Salty. This is what I was thinking of. There is a uniquely named mud crab, and I think he looks unique, too. Let's compare him to the others. Yeah, he's got barnacles and stuff on him. Yeah, this is Old Salty. I knew there was something about this location. Yeah, cool. Okay, so we need to drop some stuff. Let's see, what do we have? I think we'll drop the Daedric Sword of Immobilizing, which, as I figured, is a paralyzing enchantment. We should be able to go now. Okay, yeah, Mirak's sword seems to be doing a lot, but we need to test it on a bunch of different stuff to truly see. And I think we will stick with this. The enchantment runs out fast, though. Look at that. But what we could do is use some soul gems so that we could also increase our enchanting a little bit, because I think using a soul gem on an item without charge does increase enchanting a tiny little bit. So let's go into Miscellaneous and find Azura's Star, and we'll just have to remember to keep filling this up, the Black Star, yeah, filled with a greater soul. Oh no, we need to go to our weapon. I rarely recharge weapons, so that's why I usually forget. Okay, where's Mirak's sword? There we go. So RB to charge, and then we can grab the Black Star. Boom. And that should fully charge it. Not sure how much that rose our enchanting by. Or increased our enchanting by, I should say. But nevertheless, there we go. Can we wait? Yes, we can. All right, we're going to try one more location only, to find the Strident Squall. Unless we can, like, see it. Can't really see it. Okay. Let's go... Gosh, where is it? Let's go to Hackmere Shoal. Just see if we can see a ship icon. The only reason I'm not going to go to, like, every location around Solstheim is because it could still be in Skyrim. I don't think it is. I think we picked up this miscellaneous quest here. Hi, Pirate Captain! See how much damage Mirak's sword does against somebody that is obviously a bit higher level. Also, of course, we have a stamina enchantment, which doesn't seem to be doing anything whatsoever. Still, like, attacking as normal. That's why I don't really value stamina. Oh gosh, I can't talk this episode. That's why I tend to value stamina absorption lower than other enchantments. That's what I was trying to say. Okay, not too bad. This does seem like a powerful sword. Not too bad at all. We'll take his 250 gold. Do we see a ship? No, but since we're here, we might as well go ahead and activate this location, because we no doubt will have to go here. We have to go to most of these places for quests. So, what is this place that we have found? Frostal. Yes, that... Oh, there's an Easter egg in there. I remember this place. I'm not sure if it's tied to anything. We'll have to come back at some point, or do it now. I have shown off that Easter egg in an Easter egg video. Okay, no location of the Strident Squall. We'll keep an eye out for it, though. Asked Dior about Baldur's disappearance. Oh, this was from the skulls. So this is something to do with Dragonborn. Let's do that one. Yeah, there's the Skull Village. Okay, yeah, so these four. We can go explore Kolbjorn Barrow. We also need to go back to the big, I forget what it's called, but the big dwarven ruin place, so that we can find a resonance gem. Why do I keep every single time? I know what resonance means. It's in my vocabulary. Move out of my way, fish. Okay, how's it going?
I am in no mood to talk, outsider. One of the skull has gone missing.
Who's missing?
It is Baldur Ironshaper. As our only smith, Baldur is very important to the village. I tasted one just this morning.
Let's make sure. Did anything unusual happen around the time of his disappearance?
I do not remember Baldur acting strangely. Although now that you ask, I did see something in the woods on the day he disappeared.
Not if I can help it.
I saw two elves in the far distance dragging something behind them. Hunters often visit our land, so I thought little of it.
No, it's always got to be elves, huh? Can never be a Nord or a Breton or an Imperial. It's always got to be elves, right? That do all the bad things. Where were they headed?
South and west. If your road takes you that way, perhaps you could search for any sign of Baldur.
There's no time for that.
The skull would be great.
Yeah, we call that southwest, by the way, buddy. Okay, every location we go to, we're going to take a quick peek around and see if we can't find a ship icon. All right, so we have a brand new quest, a new source of Stalrim. Baldur Ironshaper, the smith in Skull Village, who would have sold us an ancient Nordic pickaxe, but obviously we have to do this quest, has gone missing. One of the other villagers, Dior, said he saw two elves dragging something through the woods on the day of Baldur's disappearance. They were heading southwest. Search for Baldur Ironshaper. Let's see where this is taking us. Far, far, far. How did you see this? Where are you guys? How did you see this over here? Huh? Okay, am I missing something? All right, let's head to the Altar of Thrond. And then we will head over to wherever these mysterious elves were. I don't remember this quest either. Why don't I remember any of the? I've done everything. I have done everything. I've killed the guy. I don't want to spoil the guy, but the big boss in this DLC. I've done that too. What do we have here? Frostmoon Crag. Ooh, I think I know what this is.
Hold, traveler. You have no business here. Be on your way.
Wait. You. You're one of us, aren't you? A werewolf?
Then perhaps you do have business here. Forgive me. I'm Raquel of the Frostmoon Pack. Welcome, brother.
Ah, yes. Okay, for a second I thought these guys were werebears. They are not. They're werewolves. And I remember the last time I came to this location, I had already cured myself of lycanthropy, so I could not talk to these guys. So this will be the first time I've ever interacted with these guys. The last time I think they just aggroed onto me and I killed them, or somehow they all ended up dead.
Oh, did you need something?
Do you live out here?
Since I was born, my parents were members of the pack back when Majni's father was Alpha. After they died, Majni and Akar took care of me, taught me to hunt. I'm not as good as they are, but I do my best.
Have you ever thought about moving to a city?
Why? Have you seen how they live? They cower behind their walls, afraid of every ashhopper, every netch. No, I'd rather be here, free to hunt, free to live my life as I choose.
Right, free to fester and be eaten by bugs and shit in a hole in the ground. Yeah, sounds great.
Hersine, go with you.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Don't get too attached. I'm gonna cure my lycanthropy at some point. Hi there.
Welcome, brother. It's been too long since we met another who shares our blood. I am Majni, Alpha of the Frostmoon Pack. You are welcome here, so long as you respect our law.
Are you all werewolves?
Aye. The blood still runs true among some on Solstheim, as it has for centuries. We have chosen to embrace Lord Hircine's blessing. You know it well. The speed and strength of the beast, the thrill of the hunt, the triumph of the kill. This is our purpose, our way of life. So it was for my father, and his father before him. And I welcome any who walk that path.
Are there other werewolves on Solstheim?
You might find a few others. Strays, lone hunters. But ours is the last true pack that remains.
Do you have anything to trade?
Meat, furs, bone, trophies of the hunt. But those are of little use to you. There is one more thing. Since the days of the Great Hunt, our pack has kept a set of rings. blessed by Lord Hircine himself. I sense his favor on you. For you, I will part with them, if you can pay my price. Here, take a look.
Yes, I remember this. So these guys sell you werewolf rings. I'm not sure what they do, so I'm actually really interested to find out. But yeah, they sell you werewolf rings. And yeah, like I said, the last time I was not a werewolf, and I think I either aggroed them or they aggroed onto me. So interesting. Let's see what we got. Apparel. Ring of Bloodlust. While in beast form, your attacks do 50% more damage, but you also take 50% more damage. Okay. Ring of Instinct. When you enter beast form, the world around you seems to slow for 20 seconds. Interesting. Ring of the Hunt. While in beast form, your health regenerates. Okay. And then Ring of the Moon. Increases the duration of your howls by 25%. Well, these all seem very powerful, and while Adrenoch wants to get rid of his lycanthropy, he must have these. Let's see. Food? No. Miscellaneous? No. Okay, so first thing we're going to do.
Farewell.
I don't know if that sound's going to play out in the episode, but if you guys heard a little window sound there, that's because I was finishing up rendering a video. Usually, it's very rare that I record while also rendering a video, and I forgot that would happen. If we pickpocket him, he does not have the rings, which means if we kill him, he should not have the rings as well, but maybe we'll be able to find them in a chest or something.
Greetings, I don't trust you, Whelp. Keep that in mind.
Are you part of this pack, too?
For now. My pack lived in the mountains northeast of here, till they were wiped out. Damn werebears. Magini offered to help me reclaim my territory. I hunt with him until then. After that, we'll see. Goodbye, Whelp.
I'm gonna enjoy it if I have to kill you too, but we'll see.
Who are you?
Akar, Majni's brother. I hunt, he talks. Go talk to him.
You hunt? What do you hunt?
Deer, sabers, reeks, boar, bear. I hunt soon. Go bother Majni.
Alright, cool. That was a unique experience for me. I've never talked to these people before. Before we leave, we have an adept chest here. I mean, this chest was here before, so I could have been able to open this, and I don't think I ever got my hands on those rings, so I don't think that the rings will be in here. And it looks like... Okay, so what we're going to do is save right here, because it looks like they are going to see me open this.
That's close enough.
Really allowed in here.
Okay, hold on. Didn't realize what happened there, but our lock pick was on its last legs. Okay, nope, they just have some garbage. Are they gonna get angry? Okay, we're gonna kill this guy and see if we can get the rings from him. And if not, we will reload. That is way too much money to spend for those rings. That is the best that I can do. Well, I've got more, just wait. Okay, captured his soul. And now, unfortunately, because we killed him with soul tear, we're going to need to wait for him to dissipate. But while that happens, we'll reduce the rest of these werewolf trash to ash with our tentacle sword. Oh, nice. They actually took... Whoa. We killed him. What the hell? Does he have the soul tear effect on him? It looks like he does, but he's attacking me. That must be a... Whoa. What... Did someone cast... Someone must have cast, like, a fury spell, because I think we just got hit by... Oh, my gosh. I think we just got hit by a thorn there. Okay, we need to find... Well, this didn't turn out as I wanted it to. Let's see. I guess we're going to have to loot the werewolf body, then, of Mjolni or whatever that guy's name was. There's Raquel. And there's Majni. Yeah. All right, let's see. No, he does not have anything, and he has his other clothes. So, unfortunately, the only way to get those rings, it would appear, not using the console, because we don't use the console. I'm not a console kitty. The only way to get them is if we buy them, and it's just not worth it. We're going to get cured of our lycanthropy in due time anyways. So, see you later, werewolf guys. Yeah, don't think of me as your brother, because I will get myself cured. I don't want to be a dirty, dirty werewolf. It's just incredibly difficult. Well, it's not difficult to cure myself, it's just Wait, what was the thing about it? Oh, we said no and we have to cure, like, both Vickle and... No, not Vickle. Whatever their names are. Farkas and the other guy. Okay, what do we have here? Falmore, eh? Wow, already? What did I... I'm a high elf. Well, screw you guys, too. Okay. All right, you want to turn your swords on me? That's fine. That is fine. You guys probably deal no damage. I'm kind of outmatched here, though, so you mind if I make the odds a little bit more even? Feels like my sword does a lot of damage to you. Sucks, doesn't it? I find it humorous that you ask me... Oh my gosh! I don't know if that was a bug or not. That tentacle just got really, really, really big. Winkety wink. Okay, some Falmore soldiers here, so that explains the elves. We got a key to the abandoned lodge and a handwritten note. I grow impatient with your lack of progress. If you cannot break the smith, I will be forced to find a more capable interrogator. I expect your next report to contain more encouraging results. A. Huh, I wonder if we'll find out who A is. Okay, nice job, boys. They tried to outmatch me. Are you kidding me? I could have probably taken them all on. Easy. Easy. But I wanted my boys to help me. Alright, let's head into Sneak and into the Abandoned Lodge. I don't remember this either. As I was saying, yeah, I have done all quests in Dragonborn. Every little miscellaneous quest too. I found all the Easter eggs, all that stuff. And I killed the secret hidden boss. But I'm just not remembering any of these quests for some reason, which is a good thing. It's a good thing. It feels almost new, you know? Okay, we'll take the coin first.
Taken against my will. I'm in need of rescue.
What a weird thing to shout. I've been taken against my will. I'm in need of rescue. I mean, it gets the job done, but... You don't know who I am, you know? Why make yourself known immediately? Alright, how's it going?
Outsider. I remember you. You're the one who freed the skull from the dark spell. Thank the All-Maker that you have come. These accursed elves have taken me from my home.
Why would the Thalmor abduct you?
I do not know this word, Thalmor. But if you mean the elves, they were trying to learn the secrets of forging stalwart. Their leader, an elf named Ankarian.
There we go.
Has a map. He says that it shows the location of a hidden source of stalwart.
Stalrim? What's that?
Enchanted ice. As hard as iron and as cold as death. Stalrim can be forged into deadly weapons. But the art is known only to the smiths of the skull.
Where can I find this Ankarion?
They have a ship. They took me there and showed me the map. You will find it on the northern coast of the island. Please, do not let Ankarian make his weapons. Kill him or let him live. But take the map from him. It belongs with the skull. I will return to the village. When you have the map, please bring it to me there. And thank you. May the All-Maker bless your days.
Oh, you skull and your secrets. No one cares about your stupid ice armor. It's not even that good. Ugh. I have a unique set. I have a Death Brand set, sir. I would love to show you that and get your opinion. My mom is calling me. Huh. Let's do this. Hello?
Hi.
Hi, Mom.
Hi, Austin.
Hey, Mom.
You're
being recorded right now. I'm literally in the middle of doing the biggest series on my YouTube channel.
Oh, I always wanted to be on your show.
Is there anything that you'd like to say to all 182,000 people?
182,000? 82,000. Okay. Oh, okay. Well, enjoy whatever game you're playing. I know that I know absolutely nothing about video games or whatever you're doing right now. But I know it sounds like a lot of fun, and pay attention. You'll take notes. Very important.
No, it's more personality based, Mom. Don't tell them that. They're gonna think that I keep telling you that I'm the best Skyrim player that's ever lived. Mom, what? Just a quick question. I'm sure this is burning at the top of all of my viewers' minds. What's your favorite Elder Scrolls race?
Race?
Yeah. You got your Bretons, you got your Argonians, you got your Imperials. What do you think?
The second one you said.
The Argonians.
Yeah, that one. Yep.
You like the giant lizard, the lizard people that are immune to disease and can swim through water and hold their breath.
Yes, because those are good things to have, very useful.
Yeah, that was my thought process when I played Morrowind all those years ago, and that was my first character, because I figured, you know, if you can swim underwater indefinitely and also be immune to disease, that's pretty good, you know?
Right.
Yeah.
Yeah.
All right, well...
Antibiotic.
Yeah. Okay, Mom, well, I'm going to finish up this episode. I'll give you a call afterwards, okay?
Okay. I love you, honey.
I love you too, Mom. All right.
Keep up the good work.
Okay.
Bye.
Bye. All right. Yeah. Okay. Well, that was my mom, ladies and gentlemen. I love my mom a lot. She's a great mom. So, yeah. Anyways, right back to this. Where are we at? Okay, we got about 4 minutes. Well, I'm sure there's going to be at least one person that's like, ugh, did he really talk to his mom and waste valuable time in the Let's Play? It's calm down. It's a little funny, right? All right. Let's get back to this. What we were doing. I've been called before, but I never actually answered a phone call, I don't think, on camera. Okay, retrieve the stallroom source map. Yeah, let's go ahead and go to North Shore Landing. Look at that! We already went to that place. We set that place up. It's almost as if I knew, but I didn't. I assure you, I did not know. Yeah, to this day, my family thinks that I, like, show you guys tips on, like, how to maximize efficiency in these games, and it's more personality based. I'm not the best, you know. When I play Oblivion, I've got a lot of knowledge, but most other games, I'm just along for the ride.
You are trespassing here. I strongly suggest you move on.
I have business to discuss with your leader.
You will find him on the deck. Any hint of treachery, and your life is forfeit.
Oh, there's gonna be some treachery. You just wait. I got a whole mess of treachery for y'all.
Leave at once. Do not test me, or I promise that you will regret it.
I'm here about the stallroom map.
So you know my purpose here, then. I suppose you must have found that dullard of a blacksmith. Unfortunately for you, my mission here is also a secret. To protect it, I have no choice but to silence you. Now, give me one good reason that I should not kill you where you stand.
Leave this island now, or your life is forfeit.
I can see that is no idle threat. Very well. We will depart the island once we have loaded the ship. No weapon is worth dying for. Not even a weapon forged from a starboard. Here, give this map to the blacksmith. I have no further need of it.
Wow, that actually worked? Wow, dude, you're a loser! Wow, Ian Karen.
Leave at once. Do not test me, or I promise.
Dude, look at me! Look at me! I'm the captain now. You suck! I'm gonna jump all over your ship! Wow, I can't believe that worked. That never works. Even though we're, like, super powerful, and it should work. Like, we will kill them, but... Okay, cool. Wow, that was, alright. Well... Yeah, it's just it's very rare if you don't have a speech character with the intimidate perks and all that stuff that you can just say, nah, how about you leave? And they're like, okay, all right, chill out, chillax, especially like the Thalmor. Don't talk to me,
I can feel it. The tree stone is free again. The oneness of the land is restored. Does that mean, is it over? Is Mirak defeated?
I killed Mirak, but Hermaeus Mor is still out there.
It was Mirak who threatened Solstheim. With him gone, Herma Mora has been foiled once again. Tell me though, my father's death, was it necessary? Was there no other way to destroy Mirak?
Hermaeus Mora killed Storm, remember? Not Mirak.
I know. The Skull will not forget this. Storn's death will become another of the many tales of Hermamora's treachery. One more thing, Storm. If you will. I know it is not my place, but may I offer a word of advice? Of warning?
I don't need your advice.
I understand. Walk with the All-Maker, Dragonborn.
Well, crap! I'm kind of curious as to what she was going to say, but Adrenoch does not need advice, and I think that's what he would say. Okay. All right, well, we're going to end this episode here, ladies and gentlemen. I think once we give this map back, we'll be able to start another leg of this quest. I could be wrong, but I think that's how it is. And we've got Kolbjorn Barrow to explore and many other things to do in the Elder Scrolls V Skyrim Special Edition Dragonborn DLC. Thank you guys for watching. I'm sure my mom says hi, and she loves each and every one of you. And I'll see you guys in the next episode. Bye-bye.